We've got to learn to depend on Jesus. Well, Jim and I found that He's been a friend. He's been God. He's kept His word. He's always been there. He's kept us through all these troubles and trials. And I believe if we hold on to His unchanging hand, Brother Jim, we can make it all the way home. One day soon, He's coming for a people. Brother, I'll tell you, I just want to be one of them, but He's going to find a way for me. But we ain't got time to get away from down here. You know, disappointments is going to come, Brother Jim. People's going to come to back on us. Going to try to tear you down. But God knows we've got a short time to work. And the devil is trying his very best, Brother Jim, to discourage us and get us sidetracked. But we ain't got time. We got to keep on keeping on for Jesus. And God knows His people's coming in. We just got to keep on running this race with patience. Because I'm telling you, boy, it's time to get excited about what God's got in your life. Because we don't know who we're going to take our last breath. Don't know who we're going to come to church our last time.
That's right.
We need to get our works in while we can.
Yes.
I'm going to try to sing one more song. Get out of the way. Yes. Get in tonight. Let the Lord bless you. If you got a song, sing. Testify.
Yeah.
God's got what you need. I love this little song. I know I sang it a lot. I found a way, Brother Jim. I think I quit. I tried everything and they was a try. And I found when I tried Jesus, I found everything that I needed all along. I want to bless the word of this song. I was searching the saddest.
Thank you. Push ourselves and gold, we can blacken it on devil's eyes.
Right.
Brother Mike, you like no more than nothing, and the brothers just stay home, they will not go, they forget to stay home sometimes. So you go by the field, and he'll send something to ride along with to help you ride along with your feet. Hey man, I don't know how many people are living in a present time. We gotta put this stuff behind us. We gotta keep our mind laid up and our eyes on the prize, amen. Because this ain't winding up right before, right? Amen. Brother Mike, I believe it ain't much longer, Brother Mike, amen. Praise God, this world can't stand too much more of what's going on.
But
I thank God, I want to be ready. I want to keep pressing on. Amen. I don't care what the enemy throws my way, Brother Mike. I ain't got no desire for nothing back out there in this world.
Love.
Keep pressing it. Something I've never had, Brother Mike, and I'm looking forward to it, as I promised to.
Love.
If I could hold up to my end of my little Brother Mike, amen, the Lord's going to hold up to him, Brother Mike.
Right.
And I get so excited, you know, we can, like I said before, we preach about this city of this place the Lord has prepared for us. Same beautiful songs about it, but Brother Mike, it ain't gonna be nothing like experiencing it for yourself, amen. I know how it feels to walk down that street and go. People say street, but I see one here read about one street. Amen. I don't know, I don't give my heart to you, but my sense ain't one. And I wanna be one of them.
Amen.
Yeah. Praise God. I'm gonna keep praying.
Desire
to pray for you. Something that's more than anything.
Yeah,
man. Love. Praise God. More than riches, wealth, and time. Thank you.
Psalms 105, just a moment.
David wrote some powerful psalms. 105, just for a moment. The Bible says this, starting the first verse. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. Call upon his name. Make known his deeds among the people. Sing unto him. Sing songs unto him. Talk ye of all his wonderful works. How many of you say amen?
Amen.
Glory ye in his holy name. Let the heart of them that rejoice, that seek the Lord. Amen.
Yes.
Remember his marvelous works that he hath done, his wonders, and the judgment of his mouth. Somebody look to him and say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
If we've ever seek the Lord, Brother Jim, we need to seek him now.
Yeah, true.
If we've ever stood on the word of God, we need to stand now.
Right.
How many say amen?
Amen. True.
I was praying. How many of us, it's hard to pray when something tries to hit your mind, Brother Mike. You pray, but it seems like you're coming in them off. And I sat on my bed at home myself. I felt so sick. I began to praise God. God gave me another song. I was singing it one service here. Brother Jim, the song says, I'd just like to ask you a question. Do you know that you're ready for the coming of the Lord? But is there something like it in your life? If Jesus called, would your work be unfinished? Well, Mike, I want my time to be in. I want to get all my time in for the Lord. Because we're running out of time. The apostle said, redeem the time. For Brother Jim, the days are evil. Evil spirits, powers of hell is all around in the church. Even at your home, the devil shows up. My home, the devil shows up. He's trying to break us, Brother Michael. He's trying to bring us down to his level. But I done read the book and I see a people. I see a firebrand people that's coming forth in these last days and doing the same works that Jesus himself done before he left this earth. You can say, Brother Paul, I don't read that. We're living in a time that the latter rain is just about to be poured out. Can somebody hear what I'm saying? The latter rain is greater than the former rain that fell at Pentecost. That was the former rain. That's what Joel prophesied. That he would pour his spirit out. But this latter rain is going to be greater than the former. And Jesus is fixing to send it. He's fixing to send a move of his spirit that to astonish the eyes of the people that's going to be standing by watching these miracles. You can say, Brother Paul, I don't believe it's coming. Honey, I know it's coming. This is the season that God is going to rekindle the fire among his people. How many can say amen? It's time to get life for Jesus. It's time to get on fire for the Lord and say, Lord, speak to me. I'll do the work. Tell me, God, I'll do the work. He's chosen a firebrand.
Yes.
Come, I feel this.
Thank you.
Now, preaching uncompromising word.
Thank you, Jesus.
The word wants everybody to compromise with them.
Yeah.
Pat them on the back and say, honey, you're all right just like you are. But I'm going to tell you, we've got to get it right.
Come on.
Yeah. I might say, get it right. Right now is the time that we search your life, search your soul, search your mind, search your heart, and say, Lord, I'm seeing the word, Brother Mike, what God is raising up a people that's going to trust more in their God than in what the doctor said. Amens on that. I said he's raising up a nation of people that's going to believe what thus said. The word of God will come to pass. And God said, honey, you got to back that word up. He will not be God if he failed one place in his word. He said, let every man be a liar, the word of truth. And that means a woman too. If you come against the word of God, you ain't nothing but a full blooded liar. The word is what sets us free. The truth of that word. Many people down the doctrine of God. Many people down through the Old Testament into the New. Got in trouble with God. How many say amen? How many men have sinned? And I preached on him several different times. He had anointing the blessing of God upon his life. And he got to play around with the devil and laid his head in the lap of the devil.
Yeah.
And he began to lie.
Yeah.
And I kind of imagine this here, I said it before. She probably sat and was laying in her lap and looking at her. And she probably had eyebrows. I said this before, looked like windshield wipers. Believing in Samson. And she said, if you lie to me, you won't lie to me again.
Come on.
Yeah. If you really love me.
That's law.
That means they'll have your wife. I'm going to have your husband say, honey, if you really love me, you buy that thing for me.
Come on. That's
law. Now, if you don't raise your hand, I'm going to pray for life. So we get
come on. That's law.
I'll say that myself. You see, if Moses raised a hand, ain't he? You laid Samson in her lap. How many goes? Oh my God, what a mess. You laid Samson in her lap, sitting in a trap. I might write a song. But she kept after Samson's heart.
Right.
Tell me if you really love me. Oh, if you love it, you keep in the bargain, buy this for me.
Come on.
If you really love me,
that's all.
I sure would like to have that new fishing boat.
That's all.
I'm getting a phone cross.
Yeah.
It was forbidden for Samson to reveal where his strength lied at.
Right.
Because I can date people. That's messing and playing with God on Sunday and live like a pit of hell on Monday.
Come on. Yes, sir. Yeah.
God's raising a holy nation, a holy people that's going to take God's word. God said, you don't do this, then don't do it. And God said, you do this, then you're going to do that. But this fellow lost his anointing. He couldn't be wicked. He took a gate and a hinge focus. Ripped chorus to pieces.
Amen.
It couldn't bind him.
Right.
But he revealed his secret.
Yeah.
Delilah finally got to his heart.
That's right.
If you really love me, Samson, you tell me. Well, she kept on and she broke him.
That's right.
Because Samson was lusting after that Jezebel.
Right.
He revealed his secret while he was sleeping. But long story short, she called a meeting and come. It's changed. And they hollered, Philistines is coming! Philistines is coming! He jacked up Brother Mike and he thought, well, I'll do this. I've done it before. I ripped the gate off the hinges. I'll kill that woman. But this time when he jumped up, he's like, Lord, every man. He lost his anointing. He got out of the will of God. It's like so many right now in this church. Every Jesus name church should be full of people praying and say, God save my people. Save my babies, Lord. Save my grandchildren. Save my grandpa and grandma. Save all of them, Lord.
Yes, sir.
Satan is blinded.
Amen.
You come into the middle, so I feel like saying this. Can't be plucked his eyes out and make sport of him, make fun of him.
Right.
Hook him to the ground and wheel.
Amen.
Round and round and round he went. But there was something going on. I believe he recognized and began to worry. I feel and that little lad, you know, with him, Samson said, took my
hands on two pillars holding up the building.
Yeah. Right.
He was getting reconnected, says
right. Yeah.
I believe he prayed through. And the Bible said that his strength come back to him. You imagine a man in pillars might be around his corner like this pulpit.
Put them hands down and they begin to crack and crumble.
And it's absurd having a party. I like to tell the world the party's over with. Amen. Did somebody say amen?
Amen.
The Bible said he killed more and he is dead than he did all his life. Is that what the Bible said? Well, we're going to have to stand in this last day that we're living in and come against every spirit that's not like God. Satan wants to strip you of your will, of your anointing, of your desire. He wants to pluck it out of you.
Yes, he does.
Do you know that?
Bless
the Lord. I've got three Hebrew children who preach about a lot of times. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Bless
the Lord. I will not bow to the gods of this world, brother.
No, sir.
I'll never bow to the enemy. These boys knew though God could deliver them, but they said, whether he does or not, we will not bow.
Amen.
Look around us. The world was bound to the devil. And he'll find to keep him away from God and get around where the anointing's at. You hear what I'm saying, church? Many people, I know I could take a piece of paper about a bunch of names down, Brother Mike. They used to have the victory in the life.
Right.
Used to have the real Holy Ghost.
Right.
Amen.
Yes,
I'm going to say this. You've heard it said. Anybody else listen to this? You can't speak in a tongue in church on Sunday and go out Monday and cuss your neighbor out. Come back on me and wait several times. Shout your way back to the
door.
Amen. Amen, Brother Palmer. Tell me about
it.
We've got to get this thing right in here. What's in the heart will come out.
Amen.
The mouth speaks from the abundance of the heart.
Yeah.
I want my heart to be full of the Word of God and full of things that God wants us to do and tell the people time's running out. It's getting dark in the natural. But it's about this lady in the spiritual.
Yeah.
The Bible said, work while it's these things winding down. I pray to God you get on par for the Lord before this summer's over.
Because
our nation's in trouble.
Yes, it is. Amen.
God's got some mighty angels of war. Hallelujah.
Wow.
He's going to dispatch across this earth to bring his wrath and judgment upon an ungodly nation that ain't even fit to live.
Amen.
You hear what I'm saying? I don't believe it in me, Brother Paul. I believe in telling the truth.
Come on.
If you ain't right, you're wrong.
Amen.
If you ain't holy, you're unholy.
Come on.
If you ain't sanctified, you're sanctified.
Yeah,
well, I thought you got sanctified, it's sanctified.
Come on.
Sometimes I believe it's in the spirit realm. If you can look, you can see someone's tongue about long as a necktie.
Come on. That's right.
Amen. There's a war upon people sowing discord.
Yes, sir.
Amen. When you get a war put upon your life with my God, you're in trouble.
Amen. Yes, sir.
I don't want to be in discord, so
anyway.
I'm going to sow peace, love.
Amen.
It ain't no wonder the Lord said charity was the best gift. I mean prophecy, but if you got prophecy, you're going to have charity. Amen. Charity never fails, but prophecy edifies the body of Christ. Yeah, prophecy sometimes will warn you things to come. I warn you not to do this, and you better do that.
Right.
That's prophecy.
Yeah.
God uses and gives.
Right.
And I want to encourage you, all of us.
Cool.
I'm searching myself daily, Brother Mike.
Yes, sir.
I don't know anything in my life that I'm doing that's wrong. If God showed me, said, son, you just have your life.
Right.
It'll be on my life all day that if I had something in my life.
Yes.
I don't have time to play around with the Lord and say, Lord, I'm working on this.
Yeah.
I'll try my best, Lord. I'll do what I can, Lord. What he said that when he went to Calvary. So, well, I'm going to do my best. I'd like to get out of it.
Come on.
He done it all for you and for me. He done it all, brothers and sisters,
yes.
So we can live.
Amen.
When this life is over.
Thank you, Lord.
Revelation, Jesus, that the gates of that city, I'm trying my best to hurry. Nothing undefiled is going to enter into the gates. Can you hear what I'm saying? I preached a message one time years ago. People was going to have gate trouble. And a supposed to be a preacher told me, said, well, there ain't no gates. I guess he ain't read Revelations.
Come on.
Or hadn't read Revelations.
Yeah.
There's 12 gates to the city.
Yes. Yes, it is.
Is that what the word says?
Yes.
And each one of them gates for the gym is a solid pearl.
Man,
I want to see what it feels like, Sister Angel, to step on the street of gold 1500 miles from home. It's ours. The Lord went down and made this place for the office that we can enjoy heaven. Why eternity rules someone? Somebody said, what do you want to spend eternity? Spend something you got rid of. You can't spend eternity. It has no end. Time has an end. When that angel, I say this many times, probably says I've been preaching. One day he's going to sit down. He's going to put one of his foot on land and one on the sea. And he's going to declare that time shall be the Lord.
Amen.
That's when time is done away with. Eternity. We stepped out of the veil of time into eternity. Lord have mercy. I wrote a song a long time ago. Time, when it means eternity, what have you done with your time when the end comes? I'm going to work, Brother Mike. I'm going to get my time in.
Amen. Yeah.
Amen. I'm going to go to church.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Somebody said, what do you mean going to church? I'm going to go to a chance I get. I told the Lord, I said, you open the doors.
Yeah.
And I'll go, Lord.
Well,
set that big tent in the bank. I think it's big. Well, I think so. I'm going to sit at the door and some of them come in the circus. I said, you bring all these clowns out here, we'll set them free.
Amen.
Someone said, well, that looks like a circus tent. I said, you bring all the clowns here, we'll get them set free.
Come on. Yeah.
I'm serious.
Amen.
Here at Memphis and Rushmore, we'd be one of the town populates.
Oh, blood.
Boy, they drive. I look at a bunch of idiots up at Rushmore. I seen the brush harbors full of the dogs. I saw people laying from outside of the ground. They was able to work and heal, set free. God's power moved out here in the middle of a cornfield. Amen. How many can say amen?
Amen.
This world, he would do if it would be God. The town would have to work 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Clean up the burnt spots in the road. I scored. We'll be done with a pile of good, buddy.
Come on.
Somebody said, you shouldn't say that, brother Paul. Honey, they think I'm good. If you wait till Jesus puts his judgment on his wrath. How many to say, man?
Bless the Lord.
I don't believe that Jesus that Ethan says is hoodoos and doo-doos and dummies and everybody else.
Come on.
watches it. Every time I go, he spends more time with the office than ever with me. He said, "Tomorrow we're going to talk about Bible." And I thought that's so wonderful. He wants to know about Jesus and about healing and about all this stuff. I believe I could almost convert him.
Amen.
His wife had to come and crack me over and tell him to hurry. I said, "Oh, that mommy's in there with us."
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
He's asking about evil spirits and could a person get rid of them and on the post had an evil spirit in him. I said, "No, you can't. When it possesses you, when it's on your mind, you've got a free choice." Well, I feel this.
Right.
When you've got a hold of your mind, you've got a choice to make to come to Jesus, and Jesus will lift that off of you. But when the devil possesses you, it's different from being oppressed of the devil than possessed of him.
Right.
All the way here, come out, it's like the man in the tomb across the sea where Jesus casted out the legion of demons. Through the name of Jesus, somebody, Holy Ghost filled, baptize Jesus' name, living holy, sanctified.
Yes, sir.
How many games in the Bible world? I've got to say that.
Bless him, Lord.
I believe he had seven sons of Cephas.
Yeah,
huh? They saw Paul casting out devils in the name of Jesus. Well, they felt real tough, Brother Jim. And they said, we'll cast them. We'll cast them out. Use the name of Jesus. But when they try to cast that devil out, the Bible said the devil attacked them and they fled naked, tore them all pieces.
Yeah.
And the devil spoke out, said, "Paul, I know, Jesus, I know, but who are you?" That's telling me, that's the evil boy's got in trouble right there around the swamp. I preach a message, preach this talk, as it's a God for. Don't stir something up if you can't handle it.
Come on, that's true. Amen.
Don't stir something up if you can't handle it.
Amen.
And I got Bible for what I'm saying.
Amen.
Amen. They didn't dead beat around with the sick people or them that was possessed. Paul was so anointed. And April from his body. And all the sick people had to do is touch him. Back up a million words, see if that ain't what happened.
Yeah.
Brother Jim, they were healed. Evil spirits left.
Amen.
This move of God is coming. The power of the Holy Ghost is going to move through his people like you have never seen.
Amen.
Now, I've got to say this, because we will be seeing some people delivered of evil spirits for long.
That's
right. The worst thing you can do is grab your babies and run out to the car.
Come on. Yeah.
Come on.
That's right.
I'm going to tell you something. If I've got the power to cast the devil out of somebody, through the name of Jesus, I've got power to bind him over all the people sitting around us. Amen. I saw it now. You run outside, so I'm going to get away from the devil. Honey, the Prince of Power is there. He'll come out there and sit down on the side of your car.
Right.
If you ain't right with God, the best place you can be. It's right in amongst the world that knowing in this world. That's people in spiritual prisons that their scale cells need to be unlocked. Because the person possessed with the devil cannot free yourself. And I can pull this out of the Bible. Remember the fellow that brought the young man to Jesus? I think it was a boy. The disciples tried to cast him out, and they couldn't do it. Come to Jesus and ask you, what can we cast that spirit? This kind comes forth by nothing but prayer and fasting. You can bark up the devil's tree till you turn blue. If you ain't got the goods, you better sit down and be quiet. Amen, church. We saw them come out screaming, crying, cussing, spitting. We saw that. This great move of God that's coming amongst the church people of God. You're going to see people delivered because they are in spiritual prisons. They cannot free themselves. This is why you see people come to the altar and repent. Supposedly.
Come on.
Leave the church and never see them again.
Come on.
They didn't get delivered.
Come on, that's right. Amen.
I'm telling you right, church. I'm telling you the truth.
Yeah.
In the spirit. Somebody said, Brother Tom, I don't believe in the spirit. So you probably have got one.
Come on.
This doctor.
Did you like that this morning? I'm trying to hurry.
Come on.
And he's from India. And they got, he called what kind of gods they call him. He said, I told him one God, his name is Jesus Christ. Everybody knows you be around somebody long enough, the sun's going to rub off.
Everybody
knows that.
Yeah.
I'll sit there and talk to him all day if he wants to talk about the Word of God. The move of the Spirit. Church, let's get hungry. Please let God, let's get hungry. Don't you worry about what people says or what people's done. God's going to have the last say.
Yeah.
I said God's going to have the last say.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what people do today. The pastor was beaten, stoned, and run out of town with a mop.
It was.
Boy, can I honor go to jail for Jesus for a week or two?
That's
all.
That's
all. I got your attention
that time.
I said I would count it an honor for them to come in here, cut me and stuff me, to burn jail by a week or two. We make the jailhouse fun. I Paul and did. I'm serious. You think I sat there in the corner of Boo Hoo Pack? I tell somebody about Jesus. I said, let me have one of my old guitars to take in here. Hey, man, they probably let me out for my time. That's how we need to feel. Don't be afraid of the devil. Paul and Silas went in there. They didn't boo-hoo and cry and bawl. Well, look what you've done, Paul and Silas. You ain't opened no big mouth, we wouldn't be here. But they begin to sing. Praise God.
Thanks to God.
And the Bible says along about midnight, I believe that's where he got that jailhouse rock song, huh? Amen. God sent an earthquake and shook the jailhouse. Never know when that song goes.
That's right.
Because two little boys in our praying side.
That's right.
That's right. I believe that, the Bible. I believe the hunger we get from God, the more the devil's going to fight you.
Right.
He'll try to camp out on the front porch.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
When you get hungry to live for God like you never have, honey, the devil's already got a plan.
Amen.
I've got to stop this. They're going to go too far.
Come on.
Well, some of us have done went too far and the devil can't stop us.
Amen.
Everybody can go to that place in the Lord. That you just go far enough, he just get out of there. Most people, they sit there, somebody please stop me. Oh, the poor little daughter. Sniff with them bad times.
Come on.
The dryer blowed up, the refrigerator quit working.
Come on.
Car ran out of gas. That's exactly what the devil wants you to do, to sit down. Somebody please pick me.
Come on. Pick me one time, Michael. Please pick me, son.
Come on.
That's what
flesh likes. He don't like to say that. Paul, straighten this thing up and shut your mouth.
Amen.
Going out, look in that mirror and say, you ain't going to cause me to slow down no longer, boy. Somebody say, you lost your mind. Yes, right. I lost it a long time ago for Jesus. Talk to the flesh.
Come on. Yes.
Talk to the devil. things come to your mind, get in that mirror and say, devil, you get your foul hands off my mind. In Jesus' name, I'm going to tread upon you. I curse you. Pray in this little while, you'll feel. You'll find that little thief will sneak out.
Amen.
He wants you to stand on and sit there on his shoulder. Yeah, you love people. I don't think nobody loves me no more than church. I don't need that a lot. That's the love that I get used to. When I got one spoke up. I really had a bad time. She fixed my brakes and burnt my biscuits.
Did you know in the Old Testament, I'm God's truth. In the Old Testament, Moses allowed them to build a divorce room for anything. They come in that evening and they burnt the serpent. Amen. Just write them on a piece of paper, right, and send them down the road. But Jesus said it wasn't so from the beginning.
Amen.
There's only one thing
that
you can put your mate away for.
Right.
Jesus said, saving for fornication.
Right.
That's adultery.
Amen.
That breaks that marriage as though that person died.
Yes, sir.
Actually, it did die spiritually.
Yes. Amen.
And that oneness connection that these two become one.
I tell you. Bless him all.
And one of them wasn't faithful. That one that was faithful, I can take this word of God right here and prove to you, you have the right to put her away or him away.
Amen.
Bless God, I don't want to live, Sister Bob, she can never do this. I'm just using me and her, so she won't get mad at me. You think I said, she went out with a boyfriend and come home and said, honey, I'm homeless, David. I said, honey, here's your clothes on the front porch.
Yeah.
I'll help you load them up. And all I want to see of you is your tail lights on the outside.
Come on. Amen. That's right.
That won't cost you nothing. It doesn't hurt y'all.
Come on.
The people have beat each other to death. I'm going to say this.
Come on.
Over the years.
Yes.
When I'm getting to help you, Jesus.
Come on.
Come on.
I had people, uncles, that are gone to heaven, I hope. I said, a woman can't do nothing in church. But said, I'm sick. Well, bless God, if I was a woman, I'd stay home and I'd ask him when he got home. Why does she want to go to church? She can't open her mouth.
Come on.
People are so mixed up in traditions of the elders, old people that had it wrong.
Come on.
How can a woman keep her mouth shut and y'all prophesy upon thy servants and handmaids? I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh.
Amen.
Your sons and
that killed that belief one out.
Daughters shall prophesy. Well, I'm getting in trouble probably. And I've got some people says, let's stop. I'm gonna tell you a case that I know for a fact. This little woman, good church woman, faithful to church, come home, Brother Tiff. And her no good husband, drunk, alcoholic, beat her like a dog every time she come home from church. She got tired of him mistreatment. And I reckon going places she should go. She couldn't take it no more. She left him. Divorced him. And the preacher, well, she went to church too, Brother Mike. She married this man that was a Christian man. And treated her like a queen, you know what I'm saying? That pastor had enough gall to tell that little woman, that you're going to hell if you don't go back to that drunk. I tell that Patsy's the biggest fool in the county too. I don't expect you to live with somebody that mistreats you. Now if they don't sin on you, they don't commit adultery and run around, you can't put them away if they choose to live with you. I've got to say this. But so help me to God, if they betray that trust, you can never have a perfect marriage again with that person. Back up and read what I'm telling you. Jesus said, he was talking about Moses getting a bill of divorce. Jesus said, that's so from the beginning. What was so? Divorce was put away for any old reason. Jesus said, saving, back up. If you don't say that, I'll repent before this church. Saving means accept. This is the only way, only reason. You can't put away if she's a sinner.
Come on.
Did she choose to deliver you? I got to say this. You've been a Christian, you can't put her away because she's just a sinner.
Come on.
Right. She chooses to deliver you. Right. And it's faithful to you in that for his husband and wife. The Bible says, the apostle said, how do you know the sanctified one may sanctify the unbeliever? But that's talking about two categories. A woman or man that betrays that trust, they died and they did the deed.
Amen.
Amen. I'm going to pray with the word of God.
True.
And this woman, she may have died lost. She looked at that preacher and said, I can't do it. I can't go back to that man that beat me. Pulled around with a hard head. Well, I wouldn't live with a dog like that, brother Michael. If he had gold nuggets sticking out of his ears. And I'll say this here, it ain't much of a man. I'm going to do it. He's lowering a snake's belly beating up on that little woman. Yeah, they didn't get out there and get somebody eagle-hating and just beat the bar out of each other.
Right.
They running down the town and get out here. See, yeah, to beat that little 110-pound woman. Man, I'm saying it. Play it on YouTube. I don't care. Don't call me. I'll have a long talk with her. Yeah, Jesus said he's going to do Jeff. Long talk, that boy. I'm telling you the truth. The churches, this little schism that the pastor being over years is hitting the church.
Amen. That's right.
When you repent and get converted, the Bible says, anybody can repent, but anybody's not going to get converted. Converted means to change. You're not like you was.
Amen.
When Jesus forgives you,
well,
I've done ended up coming out of all the demons. I'm going to score here.
Come on.
That little woman that Jesus met at the well.
Come on. Bless him, Lord.
Jesus told the disciples, said, I need to go by Jacob's well.
Yeah.
He knew this little woman was coming there.
Yeah.
Her life was messed up. Her life was in shambles.
Yeah.
Wrecked. Devil threw her from here to yonder. She was sitting on the well with the drop water. Jesus began to tell her. Jesus knew how many husbands she had.
Amen. Come on.
Jesus, the one's not a husband. She said, Lord, I have none. She was shacking up with the one she was with.
Yeah. Right. Amen.
Back in the ring.
Word.
Jesus said, you have had five husbands. And the one you got now is not young.
Amen.
You live with somebody else.
Right.
I believe, Brother Mike, the Lord broke his little heart that day after the way.
Oh, yes, sir.
She got so excited. She ran off and left her water pot.
Yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus gave her a drink that day.
Yes.
That little woman had never experienced in his life.
Amen.
Am I telling you the truth?
Yes, sir.
She went running into the city. Said, come see this man that's told me everything I have done.
Amen.
Come and see.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Jesus loves the adultery. He loves the fornicator.
Amen.
loves the prostitute, he loves the dope addicts, he loves the drunk, he loves the murderers.
Amen.
His redemption, he died for all.
Yes, he did.
And his blood can cleanse you. Like I got a song the Lord gave me a while back. It's not where I've been or what I have done.
Right.
It's what I'm doing now.
Amen. That's right.
It's going to be changing. It's going to be changing.
Thank you, Lord.
I kind of let me say this. I mess people up a lot of times. They look at me like I've lost my mind, but I told them, I said, I've been married 3 times. Oh, God, you should see the wrinkles roll up in. I said, the first time I married a poor girl. Second time I married a man back. And the third time I married a man back. And they couldn't figure that out, Vermont. They just kind of went, computer went, this guy, what's he talking about? I didn't know he was married 3 times.
Oh.
I can mess the devil up.
Right.
He messes so many people up. That little woman I was talking about, I don't even know if she ever got back in church and got saved right with God. They damned her to hell because she left that alcoholic drunk to beat her. Running around on her. God don't expect you to live that trash.
Oh, sir.
You're a child of God.
Right.
Have you missed that church?
Yeah,
I'm not being mean. Not being ugly. But what would I want to go to church for if God can be, just forgive me my sins? But I had a messed up marriage 30 years on the scene. This 30 years ago, and I couldn't sing in church, couldn't sing the guitar, couldn't do nothing.
Yeah.
I just stayed home and go to hell.
Amen. Yeah. Amen.
Now watch this. I'm going to finish up with the icing on the cake. God knew you before you was born. He knew you before the foundation of the world. Do you think God has put gifts in you before you was born?
Come on.
And things mess up down the road of your life and damn you to hell or something that was not your fault.
No, sir.
No, sir, he will not.
No.
He don't look in the past. He can't see the past.
Right.
He don't know you in the past of your life. Somebody said, well, God can do all, but he can't do that.
Amen.
He cannot remember.
Amen.
Brother Doc was that old person that we used to be.
Yes, sir.
He cannot. He's spiritually blocked it out of his memory.
Thank you.
He sees you at that altar, a brand new creature. Like this little woman at the well. Yeah, Jesus usually had 5 husbands. But that day forward, I don't believe Jesus could look back and see them 5 husbands.
No way. Amen.
Oh, God.
Lord,
this little woman, if she is even living now, she's a real old woman.
Oh,
I hate to be a preacher. Stand before God. Tell that little woman before she could go to heaven. She had to go back that sorry, alcoholic, wife beating, running around, treated like dirt.
Sorry.
I could go on with it, but I won't. Let's get it right with God. And let's stay right. No matter what people says.
Amen.
You serve God. You know what you got in God.
Yes, sir.
I know what I got.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Let the world get home.
Yeah.
Well,
thank you.
I hope I said a little something stirred you up and make you mad. You go home and read the Bible.
Good word. Good word. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
Well, I love the word church tonight. I counsel people. Me and Sister Barbara over my ministry. That preachers had ripped their heart that out because their life was messed up. If they repent and God forgave them, filled them with the Holy Ghost, and they got baptized in Jesus' name, they got a bunch of right to sing a song up here as I do. Is that right?
That's right.
Come on.
Because they are clean. God cleansed them. God didn't say, well, you messed up in your teenage life. I'm going to hold this against you now. That ain't God. If he done that, Brother Mike, all of us deserve hell. They got the first list. But thank God for mercy. He looked me on my faults and my failures and saw the need that I needed to save. And my Father, I praise you. I thank you, Lord, for your word. I ask you, God, to touch every need in this place. Everyone in this house, Lord, you know what each one of us needs for today. Father, I praise you. And I exalt your great name, Lord. Amen. Anybody needs prayer?
Yeah.
One of them's for you, one's for Brother Mike. Brother Mike, God's going to show you. He still cares and loves you. Lord! He opened the floodgates and let it flood in. He loves us. Sanctify your life. God, I have your power. Move, God. Open the windows of heaven.
Thank you.
Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm so tired and weary.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise him, Jesus. where I could see. And they, he said my eyes was like someone that had sugar over 500. That's how bad they're getting. And I've got a cataract starting on this side. And he had to strengthen my glasses. But I'm not claiming anything.
No, no, no.
But I need prayer.
Amen. Come on, church. I know God's going to touch you. You need your eyes to read the word. I don't care what the devil says. God's going to start backing that word up. Jesus, when you show up, things change. Catch these eyes. Catch the camera in the air. Call me in power. Let that letter rain begin to move in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah,
yes, Lord,
yes, Lord,
yes, Lord, yes, Lord,
yes, Lord,
yes, Lord,
I feel the word of power. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
My Lord, Jesus. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Glory to you,
Lord. Glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus. Bless, Lord. Thank
you, Lord. Oh, he touched me. Something happened and I